Social media, consumer fad or genuine business tool? Are the Twittering classes really going to listen to B2B brands?
There's an awful lot of people talking about maintaining the rules in the light of the changes that are going on. And I try and help them see that you're wasting your time trying to do that. It's like King Canute stopping the tide coming in, because these things are happening. The way to look at them, I think, is to recognize that these events are almost seismic shifts in our societies that have an impact on us, whatever hat we wear. You could ignore it, yet why would you want to do that? Because these conversations are happening. They are increasingly so as more people become empowered to use these online channels that extend their voices and connect with other people more and more so. So those conversations are going on whether you like it or not, in which case, why not join in and try and influence the direction of those conversations? That makes a lot of sense to me.
The guiding factors that we use are actually pretty simple. You got to trust your contributors, you got to enable users to build a community, and you got to allow people to be, you know, self-sufficient, because I don't think you can, you know, build communities as a company. I can't go out there and say, I'm going to build a community of IT managers. There's no way in the world I can do that. What I can do is provide platforms for IT managers to provide them solutions and information so that they can build their community and interact. And I can seed it with content and interact as part of the community with that.
We won a B2B marketing award last quarter for a campaign that we did called System Heroes. It was an online campaign using social networking, social media type approaches around reaching a very specific audience, a very specific tech audience called system administrators. They're typically very averse to marketing, don't want to be marketed to, but we're very interested in explaining to them our technologies and engaging with them in new ways.
First of all, we really had to find out where these people go, what they do, what they're into. We had to live and breathe and become system admins. So we had a team of three or four people at DNX who lived the life of a system admin for about a month. I can't say it was necessarily a great experience for them or for us, but they did get a lot of background information that was really important to their campaign. They're obviously into things like Second Life, Facebook, MySQL. They go on all the gadget ads. They're always looking for new jobs, so that's another way that you can get to them. And they also have the most extraordinary clothes sense.
Many of our customers, partners, prospects are early adopters of technologies. And so as a result, you know, you see some of these things emerging maybe in the tech industry first before they play out in other industries or other segments.
What businesses need to realize, if they want to get all of their people into one position, they've got to give them incentives to talk about specific topics. So, you know, give them a collaborative environment where they can actually work together to make your business better. Wouldn't it be fabulous if all of our customers and clients, whatever you want to call them, got together and actually started helping me redefine what they wanted from my business together as a group? Therefore, I wouldn't have to go and ask each one. I could get the unified feedback on how we are doing and how we could be better.
It's all about trust. Trust is one of the core tenets of successful social networking, in my view. Whether you trust your employees to say the right thing, not to land you in legal trouble, share confidential information, customer secrets, all those kinds of things, and also trust to work the way that they are most effective. There's cultural change required to make the kind of way that I work acceptable for other organizations. I talked about how I use social media and how 3,500 Microsofties use blogs and different things like that. But actually, it's very hard to quantify. And I'm actually measured on traditional PR-type metrics, number of good stories, how positive they are, and all those kinds of things. But I use social media as a means to build and continue the relationships, to do traditional PR, and also I do the hard-to-quantify stuff that's just out there and see what happens.
Behave like a normal person, as you would face-to-face, try and extend that online. So face-to-face, there is no substitute for that without any question. This probably is the next best thing.